A lot of people feel that the liberal democratic system is failing them.
Je pense que la colère était bien au-delà des taxes. Hein. Je vois vraiment ce que disent les gens, ce qu'il y a sur les pancartes. Il y en a qui demandent une société beaucoup plus horizontale, des référendums, une démocratie directe.
It was nothing to do with fuel at the beginning, was it? It's moved into something else.
Protests resembling France's Yellow Vest movement have spread across Europe, from Belgium to Germany, Sweden, the Netherlands, and the UK.
The concerns that are at the heart of this movement are also concerns in many other countries. It's an easy identifiable symbol, a little bit like the Guy Fawkes mask. In France, it's obligatory to have in your car, so everybody has a vest like that.
But while they may look the same, how do we know they're part of the same movement as their French counterparts? For one thing, who's running the show?
These movements don't have a clear, strong leadership structure or an organization that kind of binds these people together.
It's also hard to tell if all the protesters in yellow vests share the same goal.
There is a kind of tendency of these newer movements that are propelled by social media to not have clear demands or have so many demands that it becomes almost empty and that there is no clear meta-narrative that binds these fragmented issues and demands together. And that makes it very easy for the extreme right, for example, the fascists, as well as a kind of more radical left, to co-opt these movements.
But how does the symbol of a French movement, sparked by fuel taxes, become adopted by British people campaigning for Brexit?
The anti-EU sentiments that are part of the yellow vest also has to do with the kind of populist moment that we live in, where conflict is articulated between the people and an out-of-touch elite.
We want to look after our own futures, the same as they do. We want to protect ourselves and our jobs and not let the government take all the money.
The aftermath of the 2008 crisis has in many ways led to the elite becoming more richer, inequality rising, and ordinary people having paid the price for that, and that still feeds an enormous sense of indignation.
So if the wounds of 2008 still haven't healed, can we expect to see more yellow vests on the streets of Europe?
Where it will go next will depend on how political elites react. It might be the case that we need to wait what will happen with Brexit in this country to kind of see whether some people will appropriate the symbolism of the yellow jacket